A 150% rise in the Chinese government's persecution of Christians in just one year.
We don't carry arms. We will not carry arms. We don't teach carrying arms. But we can call on God. Our God is bigger than human ammunition.
Welcome back to The Fifth Seal, episode 41. I'm your host, Norm the Master's Dog Dunham, a.k.a. The Evangelical Norm. The Fifth Seal is a podcast that I do to bring awareness and prayer to our persecuted brothers and sisters around the world who are persecuted because of their faith in Jesus Christ. Every year, I count down the top 50 countries on Open Doors USA's World Watch List from January through October. Twice a month, I count down from 50 to number 31. And then throughout the month of November, which about 11 years ago I deemed to be Persecuted Church Awareness Month, I count down from 30 to number 1. It is a countdown, which is why the episode numbers go backwards. You're not going crazy. 2 weeks ago, we did episode 42. Today is episode 41. The second Wednesday in June will be episode 40. And so on through the end of November to the last day of November when we reach number 1, which is the worst country for Christians to live in based upon the persecution they endure because of their faith in Jesus Christ. So there's just a little bit of background on the podcast for those who are new. All that being said, it is Wednesday, May 25th, and this is our update on the persecuted church around the world. This from ChristianPost.com. If I can get to the headline. Muslim youth attack churches after arrest of perpetrators in murder of Christian student Deborah Emmanuel. A mob of Muslims have vandalized three church buildings and damaged and looted Christian-owned shops in Nigeria's Sokoto state after police arrested two Muslims for beating to death 25-year-old Christian student Deborah Emmanuel Yakubu and burning her body over false allegations of blasphemy. Demanding the release of the two Muslims, the rioters started bonfires and damaged the Holy Family Catholic Cathedral, St. Kevin's Catholic Church, and an evangelical church, Winning All, building in Sokoto. They also damaged and looted dozens of shops belonging to Christians in Sokoto City, Morningstar News reported. The two suspects were arrested for the murder of Deborah Emmanuel, a member of the evangelical church Winning All, who was also a student at the Shehu Shigari College of Education. A video of her killing went viral on social media. A portion of her, you can't see it. We're not going to show the video. Hundreds of Muslims here in Sokoto this morning converged at various points in the city to protest the arrest of two Muslims who were involved in the killing of Deborah. Area resident Angela Anthony was quoted as saying, quote, in spite of efforts by the police and other security agencies to prevent them from becoming violent in their protest, these Muslims still succeeded in attacking and destroying, unquote. The Reverend Christopher Omotosho, the spokesman for Sokoto Diocese, said the protesters also shattered the windows of the Diocese Bishop Lawton Secretariat and vandalized a bus parked on the premises. They also attacked the Diocese Bakita Center in Elayu Jodi Road and set a bus on fire, he was quoted as saying. Deborah, who lived with her parents in Sokoto, was beaten, stoned to death, and her body set on fire as she was falsely accused of blaspheming the Islamic prophet Muhammad because she had refused to date a Muslim, sources were quoted as saying. After Deborah's body was buried in her hometown in Niger State Saturday, her parents told the local media they had left everything to God. Quote, we can't say or do anything except to take it easy as an act of God. We have left all to God. We have decided to take it like that, unquote. Emmanuel Garba and Alheri Emmanuel were quoted as saying. The video posted on social media shows her lying still on the ground as she tried to protect her head with her left arm as male and female students gathered around, beating her with sticks, throwing large stones, and shouting Allahu Akbar or Allah is greater. And she pleaded with her classmates not to kill her. It's getting harder for me to do these stories as just like straight out kind of news stories, which I started out trying to do, just presenting them straight as news. But, I mean, when you have pictures of beautiful young women like this who were murdered because of their faith in Christ, she refused to date a Muslim student, so they accused her of blasphemy and beat her to death, stoned her to death, and then burned her body, all the while shouting Allahu Akbar, the Islamic jihadi battle cry. Around this, as she pled with them, her classmates, people that she went to school with on a day-to-day basis, not to kill her. And this is happening. I mean, I almost overlooked this story, because it's like, it seems like every story we do is something out of Nigeria, something out of Nigeria. It's like this ongoing thing. And so I was going to try to find something in India, and I'm like, no, you know what? If this is happening in Nigeria, let's keep our spotlight on Nigeria. Because within the last 10 years or less, over 10,000 Christians in this nation of Nigeria have been murdered because of their faith in Jesus Christ. Whether it be through Boko Haram, Al-Shabaab, Fulani militants, or classmates angry because she would not date a Muslim student and accusing her of blasphemy and murdering her and spreading the video on social media. This is what our brothers and sisters are enduring around the world because of their faith in Jesus Christ. Pray for her family. Pray for those students. Pray for the two who have been arrested. Pray that they will be drawn to repentance and faith, that the testimony, the witness of this young woman would cause them to be drawn to repentance and faith in Christ. Sorry, it's not good for a podcaster to be speechless. So that brings us to our World Watch List country for today, Mozambique. A few facts about Mozambique. Region is Africa. Persecution type is Islamic oppression. The main religion is Christianity. The persecution level is very high. Population is 33,230,000, of which about 18 million are Christians, so slightly over 50%. Government is a presidential republic, and the president, the leader, is President Felipe Jacinto Nyusi. So what does persecution look like in Mozambique? For Christians in Mozambique, Islamic oppression is the most common form of persecution. One Open Doors country expert shared that, quote, radical Islamic attacks have claimed the lives of many Christians, unquote. The brutality of these groups has only increased, including a prominent extremist group who has links to the Islamic State group. The presence of drug cartels in some areas is making the lives of Christians, especially church youth workers, very difficult. What has changed this year? So Mozambique joined the top 50 in 2021 after extremist Islamic attacks claimed the lives of many Christians there, and it has risen several spots in 2022. An Islamic State-affiliated group is seeking to establish an Islamic caliphate in Mozambique. Their efforts have included numerous atrocities, burned churches and religious schools, and displacement of tens of thousands of people from the northern part of the country. These attacks have allowed religious persecution, which used to be limited almost entirely in the north, to spread, and drug cartels in some areas make the lives of Christians, especially church youth workers, more difficult. In addition to the violence, pressure has increased on believers in Mozambique. The persecution of Christians is most severe in the northern areas due to Islamic State-affiliated extremists carrying out violent attacks as they seek to spread their influence and control. So some prayer points for Mozambique. Pray with churches and their leaders who have taken in thousands of families displaced by the violence. Pray that they will respond with compassion and understanding, especially towards the traumatized and vulnerable. Pray for wisdom in how to best reach these families and support them in their time of need.
Pray for economic development in the region. Unemployment and lack of basic services have left youth disillusioned and angry. As a result, many have joined Islamic extremist groups. Pray that the government and international partners will ensure that all benefit from these community projects. And pray for wisdom and provision for open doors as we determine the appropriate interventions. Pray for protection over staff as they travel to volatile regions. Pray for his blessing on all logistics. Let's pray. Father, again, we come to you and we thank you that you have provided for us a medium to come together to lift up our brothers and sisters around the world who are persecuted because of their faith in you. Lord, we praise you that you have provided YouTube and other social media that we can come together across vast distances and even over across the span of time. As many people will be listening to this or watching this video later today, Lord. We thank you that you have provided that manner for us, and we pray that you will continue to allow us to produce content on these mediums as well. Lord, we lift up the family of Deborah Emmanuel. Lord, we pray that you, as they have come to you and said, we leave all this in your hands, Lord. We recognize your sovereignty in all of this, Lord. We pray that you would bring them peace and comfort to her parents, to friends and loved ones. Lord, we pray that you would use her testimony and her witness to draw others to repentance and faith in you, even those who attacked and killed her in this horrifying incident in her own school, Lord. We pray that you would convict them of their sin, that you would draw them to repentance and faith. And Father, we pray for all of our brothers and sisters there in Nigeria as well. That as violence and atrocities continue to happen there, Lord, that you would strengthen and embolden the faith of those people there, that they would proclaim the gospel even in the face of imprisonment and death, and that you would use that to draw many Muslims and unbelievers to faith in yourself, Lord. We pray for our brothers and sisters in Mozambique. We pray for those families who have been displaced. And we pray for the churches and leaders who are taking those people in, Lord, because of the violence. Father, we pray that those who do know you that have been displaced, that again, that you would comfort them, that you would strengthen their faith, and that you would use them to be witnesses to those who have been displaced by violence who are not believers, Lord, that their joy would shine forth in the midst of persecution and pain, Lord, and that others would look at them and see that there's something that they have and that they would desire that, and that you would use the preaching of the gospel to draw those people to repentance. Father, we pray for economic development in that area. We do pray that you would provide jobs, that it would stabilize the area there, that education and religious freedom would be something that would come with that, and that the preaching of the gospel would also be increased in that area, Father, and that those that are there would be drawn to repentance and faith in you and salvation. And we do pray for Open Doors and other parachurch organizations that are in the area, that you would give them wisdom on how to reach those people who are affected by violence, by drug cartels, by Islamic oppression, and that you would use them as proclaimers of your gospel as well. And Lord, again, we just thank you for all that you've provided for us, that we can come together with the freedom to pray for our brothers and sisters who are persecuted because of their faith in you. And we do this all to bring glory to your name, because it is for your glory and in your name that we pray these things, Jesus. Amen.
Amen. Thank you guys again for taking out the time, 10 to 15 minutes twice a month, and then once a day throughout the month of November, to join us to pray for our brothers and sisters who are persecuted because of their faith in Christ. If you haven't already, go ahead and hit the subscribe button on the Evangelical Norm channel. Hit the notification bell, get all the content that is released here, or you can join the Facebook page, The Fifth Seal. And the videos and information about the countries will be released there as well. If you know anybody who would like to join us, who would be willing to take, again, 10 to 15 minutes every twice a month and once a day throughout November to join us as we pray for our brothers and sisters who are persecuted because of their faith in Christ, invite them to those two places, or if they don't have time to watch a video, anywhere they get audio podcasts, just look for The Fifth Seal, Google Play, Amazon, iTunes, Pandora, Spotify, any of those places, you can find the podcast. Just search for The Fifth Seal, download that MP3, put it in your earbuds, take it with you, and join us as we pray for our brothers and sisters who are persecuted because of their faith in Jesus Christ. And as always, preach the gospel at all times. Use words. They're necessary. Until next time, Soli Deo Gloria.